Okay, interviews never finished here at the MSX meeting. Right now, we have one old guy that we know from a lot of time, John Hassing. Hello, John. And the other one is
Robert
Vroomijs.
Yes.
Also a lot of time in the scene, I think.
Yeah. From somewhere in the 90s, beginning of the 90s. In the beginning of the 90s, 91, 92. The first fair I went to was Zandvoort 91, I think.
Wow.
And before that, I was already drawing for NMC, the Nederlands MSX Club. It's, I was, 15 years old, I don't know.
Okay. It's, okay.
Yeah, long, long time ago.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Now you've got a stand for you.
Yeah.
You have come later, because of your job. Yesterday you had to work, right?
Yes.
Okay. The thing is, you both have a project, right?
Yeah, that's true. We're both working on a new MSX2 game, platform game called Deva.
Uh-huh.
And it's a game we started, 10 years ago.
10 years already?
Yeah.
You're sure?
Your YouTube video was from 2010, I think.
Wow.
That's, but we're not, we've not been working 10 years non-stop. We started a project because Bart van Velzen, Nora Comey from Mambo 2. Yeah. He made a nice engine in Screen 4 for the MSX2.
He actually he sent me some concepts.
Yeah.
One of them, I think, also was that tower defense game that's
published
now again.
Vectroids.
Yes.
Yeah.
And one of them, indeed, was that scrolling engine.
Mm-hmm.
And I said, hey, this is looks quite good. You could make a nice game maybe from this. So that's how it started.
Yeah. And Bart had ripped graphics for testing purposes, and the question for me was just to change a few graphics so it didn't look too much ripped. But I wanted to create an entire new graphics with entire new enemies, new tiles, new worlds, and we started, and after I think a year, progress halted because what? We lost interest, I think.
Probably real life things getting in the way.
Yeah,
probably.
I don't
remember.
I got divorced in these years.
So then your mind is on that.
Yeah. I had a lot of things in my mind, and MSX was not one of them.
Yeah.
And we scroll to last year, 2019. Bart contacted me. He wanted to finish the game. He wanted to make a tech demo with all the graphics, all the music, just as is, and release it as a demo. And I said no. If we're gonna release it, we're gonna release it properly. So with entire new levels, enemies, bosses, music, all things original, no ripped graphics, no ripped sprites, nothing. And somewhere last year we started doing that. John and I are quite close friends, I think. And we both write music. John was very busy at the time, so I took a lot of my own old music and put it in the game. After a while, John joined the team, and he had his some old music that could be.
I think some old music. I also made some new tunes, especially for the game. But
explain what Project Deva is. What's the concept game?
Okay.
What you have to do?
Deva is a platform game. It's a bit like Psycho World, Phantasmal Soldier Part 2, It's a very fast scrolling game. It's made in Screen 4, the same screen as, for example, Firehawk, Space Mambo. So you can do a lot of things graphically with multi-layer scrolling in all directions. You can do really fast scrolling as well. But the main drawback is you have some limitations when it comes to the graphics. You're working in a tile mode, so you have to take a lot of things in consideration before making making something. But it's a very fast platform game with end bosses and a storyline and weapons that can be upgraded.
With a lot of special weapons to use, a lot of magic.
Are more special weapons in the game than you can have in one go. So each time you start a new game, you get another set of special weapons. Some are the same, some are different. So each time you replay the game, the way of playing is different because you have other weapons, so another strategy is needed.
I have to say that the looks of the game are terrific.
Thank you.
Fantastic.
Yeah.
It's really, really, it looks to me like the Life on Earth by Kai Magazine.
Well, that's interesting you say that.
But in Screen 4. I mean, Life on Earth was for Graphics 9000.
Yeah.
And you could notice it, but at the first look, what? Another Life on Earth. The screen mode is not Graphics 9000.
No.
Yeah, but still, it's really, really amazing.
Okay, thank you.
It's really amazing.
But I have to say, Oscar, Kenneth, Kai, he's working on the game as well. He contacted us somewhere last year that he wanted to help finishing the game. So he's making really great demo graphics at the moment.
Fine.
So the game graphics are made by me and by Paco Santos Ramirez, if I pronounce that correctly. And all the demographics, the visual scenes are made by Kai. So it's the team is getting bigger and bigger. We have two programmers, two musicians, three graphic artists. Somewhere this year we're definitely gonna finish it.
You plan to finish this year?
We try to finish it. Yeah, of course we're gonna finish it this year.
I think no it problem. Will
late this year or after the holidays.
Ooh. Not by Christmas probably. Little bit sooner.
not by Christmas, but I don't think you can buy it next month or so. So the game itself is finished by I think 80%.
Something like that, but there's so much. There's so much testing to do, and so much shaving. You know.
Do you have already videos on YouTube so people can check the results and the
progress? Do we?
Well, there are two YouTube videos, I think.
Yeah, there's the really old one that I once did.
But these videos are 10 years old.
I think. We should make a new one.
Yeah, we should make a new one, and Bart and I are thinking about releasing a promo of the game. So somewhere in the next few weeks, months, with a few levels, more as a teaser.
Okay.
Like core dump.
And then we'll lose all the data.
Yep. Yeah. Then we're never gonna finish it.
And the world is never gonna see it.
No, please don't name core dump.
It could have been a fantastic game.
It's still a tragedy, actually.
It's a tragedy of that software.
It's really sad what happened to that project. Yeah.
In the past, people thought that they was gonna end up the same way as Core Dump. We were promising start, we were promising start, but never to be finished. And I think we're gonna beat Core Dump in that way. I don't know if we're gonna beat it gameplay wise, but at least we're gonna release it.
At least it will be released. it will see the light of day. At least
some way or another on a big ass ROM cartridge.
Yeah,
I think so.
It's going to be a cartridge.
Yeah.
And who's going to produce it?
We don't
Athos,
know.
Because Mambo 2 was produced by Manuel
Somers. Somers?
I don't know.
Pathos.
Yeah. Pathos, yeah.
Okay.
But this ROM is quite big. It's 4 megabytes at the moment, and we need an SROM chip, so you can save on the cartridge itself. And yeah, we're looking for someone who can make that. But first we're gonna finish the game, and after that we're gonna see who can produce it.
Okay. Most probably.
So we don't know yet.
You will go after the usual suspects.
Yeah, indeed, the usual suspects. But we don't know which one it will be. But it's gonna get a release on a cartridge.
Okay. Yep. It's a lot of things I would like to ask you. Mm-hmm. But I guess that for the moment. To know more about your next developments, and the progress of the game. I mean, graphically, the box. I hope it's going to be a large, release.
Yeah, we hope so.
We haven't seen a touch game since.
Yeah, Mambo 2. That was the last really big game.
Of this size, yeah.
Yeah, this size.
No, this or other size. Oh. For this.
Well, yeah.
or of course, Bomberman. Shameless plug.
I mean, if it's not big, the Dutch people is not into it.
No.
Yeah, we say if it ain't Dutch, it ain't much.
we really wanted to make a good MSX2 game. There are a lot of MSX1 games.
Good MSX1 games.
Good MSX1 games, but yeah. my whole nostalgia lies with MSX2.
Okay.
So I wanted to make a really great MSX2 game. And I hope we will succeed in that. We're already planning the next game.
Yeah, several ones.
Yeah, several.
You're doing the interview by yourself. Okay, I'm going to ask this, and you are making the interview.
Yeah, of course.
On autopilot, this is.
Just give us a microphone, and we'll just talk.
We'll just talk all night. Yeah.
We only miss the beer.
Do you read my mind or something?
Well, it's just flows naturally. Yeah.
We love to talk about MSX, I think.
Yeah. Still.
But
else we wouldn't be here.
What are you planning for the future?
Should we tell?
Should we tell?
About
we should tell.
Acorn 2?
We're planning to make a sequel to Sweet Acorn. Acorn 2. Sweet Acorn 2. Yeah. We're also making a kind of
girly block kind of game.
The last mech.
For people who don't know, girly block is like you basically construct your own mech to fight with, robots with, and the way you construct your robot, it decides how fast you are and how much damage you can take and what kind of weapons you got. And we are going to add a little bit to that, more gameplay elements.
And of course, the timeless classic Yap Yum 2.
Oh yeah,
Yap Yum 2.
You can actually already play it.
Kind of. Later I will explain about Yap Yum. Somebody.
It's a Dutch classic, actually.
In Spain, that was thinking to make something like Yap Yum or Lola.
Again,
but multi sex.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, but it needs MSX2 release. But I actually coded one, and you made some nice SD Snatcher-like graphics. Mm-hmm. So we were calling it. Super deformed Yap Yum, I think.
Super deformed Yap Yum.
Yeah.
Oh my goodness.
Yeah.
By the way, does the real Yap Yum still exist?
No.
It's a museum now, I think. Yeah.
A museum on what? On prostitution. Because for the people that don't know, Yap Yum was one of the most famous warehouses in Amsterdam.
Yeah.
Yes, because Yap Yum, it actually means a mom and dad, I think.
What?
Yes, it does.
Cool.
yeah.
Knew that.
But it was full of, it was infested with like criminals and the Hells Angels and the criminal world, and actually the game that we were making, it kind of allures to that.
Okay, thank you very much for your time.
You too.
Yep.
Thanks for having this chat with us.
And thanks again. Thank you. Bye-bye.
Wrong end again. Bye-bye.
Just one thing before you drop.